Hello, my name is Adam. In this video, I'll show you how to get your app uploaded in the web store. Until the store launches, developers will need to use the Chrome extension Gallery's Upload Flow and Developer Dashboard to upload and manage their apps. So, to get your app in the store, go to the Chrome extensions gallery at chrome.google.com/extensions and click on the Publish Your Extensions link on the left. This will take you to our developer dashboard. Click Add New Item to upload a new app. You'll then be asked to select the zip file that contains your app manifest. Select the file you have created. Click Upload, and you'll be taken to a page where you will need to provide some additional information about your app. For those of you who have developed extensions, you will recognize a lot of the fields you need to complete, such as uploading screenshots, selecting the primary language for your app, providing a detailed description, as well as including links to your website and support materials. However, we have added a few more items on this page. First of all, you can select the price of your app. By default, this is set as free, but you can change it if you want to. To do so, click on the Change Pricing button. This will bring up a panel that lets you select between three pricing options: an option to keep your app free, an option to use the Chrome Web Store's built-in payment mechanism, and finally, the option to use a different payment system within your app. The first option is intended for applications that never charge any money, apps that are free from end to end. The second option, using the Chrome Web Store's payment mechanism, allows users to pay for your app directly within the Web Store. Using our licensing API, you'll then be able to determine whether a given Chrome user who's entering your app has paid or not. If you select this option, you will be asked to define the price for your app from a set number of price points. If you're setting up a subscription-based service, you can select whether to charge users per month or per year. In addition, you can specify whether users can try a free version of the app. We call this option Free Trial. With this option, users can instantly start using the free version of your app. We encourage you to integrate free trials because users are often more willing to spend money for an app after trying it out. The third option is intended for apps that use a custom payment solution. If you've integrated another payment provider, select this option. Also, select this option if the basic version of your app is free, but users can pay for upgrades, virtual goods, or other services later. In addition to the pricing options, you'll also be asked to select up to three app categories under which your app should be listed in the store. To ensure good user ratings for your apps, make sure to include your app only in relevant categories. This list will likely be updated before our launch, so feel free to suggest additional categories for your app in the free form text box. Further down is one more important section for apps. We require that you verify the ownership of the website that your app is hosted on using Google's Webmaster Tools. You will see the list of verified websites that are associated with your account in the dropdown. To verify additional websites, click the link and follow the instructions for Google Webmaster Tools. We have a lot more material on different elements of the upload flow in our documentation located at code.google.com/chrome/webstore. We are looking forward to seeing your apps in the store.